How many of you, now some of you are going to know these names of this review stuff. Some of you will know because, don't take this rudely, because you're older than I am. And some of you may not know because you're too young to know. But do you remember George Burns and Gracie Allen? Crazy couple, lots of humor. They were married 38 years, and they were on radio, stage, TV, and movies. When Gracie passed away, George just loved and adored his wife, Gracie. And when she passed away due to heart failure, of course he was devastated, and he was broken in his heart and his spirit. But Gracie had written him a note that he held close to his heart. And she said, quote, "Never place a period where God has placed a comma. Never place a period where God has placed a comma." You know, a period is what? The end of something. A comma is a space that leads to something else, right? So she again says, "Never place a period where God has placed a comma." There's hope in that statement in and of itself. And death does not have to be the end of our lives. Many of us will look and say, well, I've lived my life, I've run my course, I'm going to die, and then that's it. Some believe, well, we're annihilated. Some believe that we just go into the atmosphere, we're just a bunch of energy. But we have souls, persons that we know in ourselves, that make us who we are. And that soul will live forever. It will either live in heaven with Christ and faith in him, or it will live forever separated from God and face God hell. So we have to make sure that we don't make the wrong decision. We don't make the decision to put a period at the end of our life, but that we are willing to faith in Christ to put that comma at the end of our life. Meaning that our hope is Christ, our journey is here, but our journey continues as we follow Christ. We have to make that decision. We have to decide whether we believe in Jesus. I've heard people tell me many times, how can you believe in something that happened over 2,000 years ago? How can you believe in something that sounds mystical and unnatural? How can you believe, well, when God, the Holy Spirit knocks on our heart, and we know there's that tug, we know there's something that is happening in our heart, and we respond positively to that, and we ask Christ into our heart, and he comes into our heart, and he becomes our living Savior. We become aware of his presence. And we have a personal knowledge of him in our heart. We know that he is in us and that we are in him. And Jesus rose from the grave. It wasn't to do a ha-ha type moment to those that were seeking after him as attackers or as the followers of Jesus. He wasn't to say, look at me, and ha-ha in their face. I did raise from the dead. But you must understand that he turned the entire order of the universe on its head. Why? Because Jesus rose from the grave. People don't rise from the grave. And so he rose from the grave, and we know that he ascended into heaven, and he's there forever, sitting at the right hand of the Father. The resurrection shows us that death does not have to be the last word. A lot of people live that way. It's over. It's the last word. You don't have to make the end of our life here on earth the period. Okay? The end of the sentence of our life. Why? Because God is giving us life through faith in Christ. We know that God lives. And we know that he lives in our heart because by faith, he asks us to give us our sin, of our sins, and come live in our heart. And he will, no matter where we have been.